The Lord be with you. The Lord our God
is right and praise.
Father of mercy, faithful God, it is truly right to give you thanks. It is fitting that we offer you praise. You sent Jesus Christ, your Son, among us as Redeemer and Lord. He was moved with compassion for the poor and the powerless, for the sick and the sinner. He made himself neighbor to the oppressed. By his words and actions, he proclaimed to the world that you care for us as a father cares for his children. And so, with all the angels and saints, we sing the joyful hymn of your praise. Through life. Blessed to is your Son, Jesus Christ, who is present among us and whose love gathers us together, as once he did for his disciples. Christ now opens the scriptures for us and breaks the bread. Great and merciful Father, send down your Holy Spirit to hallow these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the leaf was his passion and death, while at table with those he loved. He took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you."
Supper was ended. He took the cup,
Again he gave a thanks and praise. Handing the cup to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The memory of Christ, your Son, whom you led through suffering and death on the cross to the glory and the resurrection, and the place at your right hand, until Jesus, our Savior, comes again. We proclaim the work of your love, and we offer you the bread of life and the cup of eternal blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ entrusted to us. Through the power of your Spirit and of love, include us now and forever among the members of your Son, whose blood and blood we share.
Lord, confess your
pardon sin, Archbishop of Manila.
Together with John Paul, our Pope,
this is the
with all
second time he has welcomed the Pope to his
and
diocese.
All those your Son has gained for you,
and the other observants at the altar are the presidents of the Episcopal Conferences of Asia,
for those who, labor
who are in Manila for the plenary assembly of the Federation of Asian Bishops.
Keep our sentence of others faithful to the example and command of Christ. Let your church be a living witness to truth and freedom, to justice and peace, that all people may be lifted up by the hope of a world made new.
Be mindful of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead, whose faith only you can know. Lead them to the fullness of the resurrection, and gladden them with the light of your face. When our pilgrimage on earth is complete, welcome us in your heavenly home, where we shall dwell with you forever. There with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, the martyrs, San Lorenzo Ruiz, and all the saints, we shall praise you and give you glory through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him we give.
has placed us in the care of Jesus, with our good shepherd, we pray a prayer of filial trust.
Let us join our hands and recite the Our Father in our native languages.
My brothers and sisters, gathered from all over of the earth, speaking different languages, we, which echo various cultural heritages and experiences, let us call upon God, the Father of us all, in the words our Savior gave us.
All the people from the various countries throughout the world now say the Our Father in their own languages. And we can say it with our Irish contingent, Ornaheratarnev, Konefadanam, Katagadriya, Kanyata the Helen Dana, Maranithiranyav, Honoron Lehu il Tordawinu, Haus Maganaviakra, Maramahmi the Darbahuna Fame, who is now Likshni Kahu, Oxershing, Obalk.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our days.